So I got a magic trick for you, Brady. I have to say I'm not much of a magician, but we're gonna try, okay? So here you go. Here's the cards. One from 10 of hearts. I'll show them to you so you see there's nothing strange. They're not marked or anything. So I'm gonna shuffle them. Let me just shuffle them a few times, okay? I've been practicing this for like 3 days.
That's three.
3 days straight, just for you, just to get this trick ready for you. What I want you to do is just choose a card and just don't show it to me. Show the viewers, but just don't show it.
I'm gonna take this card.
Okay. And I'm gonna try to read your mind. I'm gonna try to read your mind and see what card that is. Is it the Four of Hearts? Sweet. We're done. That's it. That's what I wanted to show you.
All right, thanks, man. See you later.
I'm such a bad magician. I'm actually gonna tell you how I did this. Okay. I guess a good magician isn't supposed to reveal the tricks, but I'm gonna tell you how this works. So here's the cards in order. And this might seem a little bit weird, but I'm actually gonna take the 10 out and put a joker back in. And we'll talk about why I do this in a minute. This is just to explain a little bit better how the trick works. Okay? So actually the trick is very simple. I mean, you practice it for an afternoon, you're gonna be able to do it. So all I do is just each time I'm gonna cut the deck exactly in half.
There are 10
out. So there's 10 cards. So I put 5 here, 5 here. And I just make sure that the shuffle goes perfectly, like left, right, left, right, left, right. So you see, I go like this, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. And that's what I've been practicing. You know, I was practicing on the train on the way here, everything.
I have to say, with all due respect, you weren't very fast at it. Presumably a good magician can do it.
Yeah. I mean, if you guys practice, you're going to be much better than me at this, okay?
Okay.
But so let's talk about what I did here, okay? So, you know, we started with the cards in the order, and I'm going to call the joker a zero, okay? Just to get it in. Zero, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, okay? So then what I did is that I cut exactly in half, right? So cards 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the left, and then 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 on the right, mm-hmm. Okay? And then, like I said, I made sure to just alternate left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right.
And this is called a perfect shuffle.
It's called a perfect shuffle. And so, you know, these are still cards 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are cards 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay? And so, if I did this right, which I hope I did, then when we look at the cards, they should be in the order that we just did it here. So, cross your fingers, or cross my fingers. 0, 5, 1, 6, 2, 7, 3, 8, 4, 9. So that's what I did. This is a perfect shuffle. And now, what I want to show you is actually a different way of seeing this. In mathematics, a very common idea is to try to see the same object in a few different ways. And so I actually want to do the same thing graphically. So let me start again with the cards in order. And now, let me just draw graphically what happened here. So I'm just going to write this order into this picture. So I'm just going to say, this is the order that the cards are in right now, right?
Yep.
Let's put them over here. So the cards are in the order of this shuffle.
Yep.
0, 5, 1. These are the new positions. And now what I want to do is that I want to represent graphically this perfect shuffle. Card 0, stayed in position 0, right? It stayed on top.
Yep.
The card 1 went to position 1. Card 2 went to position 2. The card 4 went over here. Card 5 went up here. And 9. Okay?
Yeah.
So you're basically seeing here graphically the trail that the cards were taking, right? And so this is kind of a little picture of what happened. And here you already start seeing more structure than maybe you would have expected, right? For example, you notice that the top and the bottom cards never change positions. And there's also this nice symmetry, right? You see that this thing, at least the picture, looks the same if you flip it upside down, yeah? And that's something that's not at all clear when you do that picture, okay? Okay, so let's go back to the cards. So I did one perfect shuffle, and now they're in this order. But let me now do a second perfect shuffle. Here we go. See, that was faster. I should have done it faster like that.
Still a bit slow, not bad.
A different way of doing this is actually just to follow the picture, right? So if I draw the same picture and just string it along here, then I'm going to be able to see what happens to this shuffle.
So draw that same pattern again.
Exactly. So I'm going to take this pattern and just transcribe it directly right next to it. Okay.
You don't even need to look at the cards.
That's right. Because, you know, this is the one thing that I have to be careful is that I'm always doing the same perfect shuffle. And if I do the same perfect shuffle, then the picture is going to tell me exactly what I'm doing. And so here I'm seeing graphically what the shuffle is doing. And so if I'm doing everything correctly, this is exactly the order that the card should be in. Okay, so now I want to keep doing this. And the other thing that I have to do in this trick is make sure that I do it the right number of times. I just needed to make sure to do this 6 times. Okay, I prepared the trick that way. I need to do it 6 times. Now, the nice thing is that we can just do everything at a time. So this one is going to go straight here. This card, for example, it keeps going like this. 7 goes like this. So this one is easier. I keep thinking I should make a carpet out of this or something like that.
The perfect shuffle carpet.
The perfect shuffle carpet, exactly. So now I'm gonna make sure to do it also with the cards. So we already did 2 perfect shuffles. Now I'm gonna do 4 more. Okay. So here's 1. Okay. Here's another 1, 2, 4. So the Joker is supposed to be on top. No, that's not too hard. I must have gotten that right. There's the Joker. Okay. Now let's follow the path of the 1. Okay. So the 1 started on top, and then it went over here, and then down here, and then all the way down here, over here. And according to this, the 1 went all the way down and then went back up. And so if I did this right, then this should be the number 1, the ace. Let's follow the 2. So the 2 started up here, then it came down here. And then maybe you start seeing what's going to happen, right? So the card 2, it went all the way down, and then it ended up in the next position. So again, if I did this right, it should be the number 2. I mean, one thing you'll notice here, actually, is that if you follow the path of the 1 and the 2, they're very similar to each other. And you might think that's always going to happen, but it actually turns out that's not what's going to happen. So if you look at the 3, it comes down here, and then it goes back up. You see, it keeps bouncing up and down.
It kind of oscillated there, didn't it?
Yeah, so it has a very different behavior. But the outcome is the same, that, you know, the 3 jumps down, up, down, up, down, up, and it also lands in the correct position. So again, if I did this correctly, it should be right there. Follow the 4 real quick, and it lands over here, okay? And so card number 4 ends in position number 4. And so again, if I did this right, it should be right there, okay? And I could keep doing this, but I can also take advantage of what we noticed at the beginning, that there's this symmetry, actually. This picture is the same upside down. And that means that if the cards 1, 2, 3, and 4 ended up in the right position, then so should the other ones, right? You know, there's the 5, there's the 6, there's the 7, there's the 8, there's the 9. And so you see what I'm doing is not any kind of feat of memory or anything like this. It's actually very simple. I just shuffled carefully in a way that when I'm done doing 6 perfect shuffles, the cards are back in the order where they started. We went like this, and then you took this one out, and then I knew that I just needed to count from here, right? Joker, 1, 2, 3, and whatever the missing one is, the 4. That's the trick. Okay, that's the trick, and you know, I like it. I think it's surprising, especially because, I mean, there's a lot of possible combinations in a deck of cards, and it's surprising that it comes back so quickly. And actually, after I realized this, I thought, well, why does it come back so quickly? Only in 6 steps. And so I thought about this a little bit harder, and I found an even better explanation for what's going on.